Quick plug here, Sonic Toast mascot stickers are now available at my eBay store. Link in the description below. Enjoy the video. Hey friends, I was thinking we'd take a different approach to Turtly Tuesday this week because yesterday we got that cool new trailer for Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles Mutant Mayhem. So I thought we'd just run through this trailer and see what kind of fun stuff we can pick out. And I'd like to start with the design of the characters. So let's start with the leader in blue. Does anything it takes to get his ninjas through? Leonardo seems to have the most traditional Ninja Turtle look with a lot of inspiration seeming to come from the action figure. We got the black belt with the double sheaths on the back for his swords, and the swords themselves, look at them, they look just like the original Playmates action figures, at least the handles do. Leo and all the turtles seem to have their initials right there on their belts, which is really cool. Leo's skin color is a cool, like, pear green. I'd say this is similar to his promotional artwork from 2003, or even his design in Rise of the TMNT. Overall, Leonardo looks fantastic. Great design. Next up, let's take a look at Michelangelo. He too looks very traditional. His head is a little bit wide and he makes a funny comment about how it is the shape of a watermelon, which is fun. His skin color is a traditional green, almost emerald like he's been in many other iterations of the Ninja Turtles. One thing you'll notice is he's definitely the little brother and he is the smallest one of the group. This is something that I believe started with the 2012 show where Mikey was more of the runt of the turtles. We saw this also in the 2014 film and in Batman vs. the TMNT, so being shorter than the other turtles is a newer attribute of Mikey that seems to be sticking. However, one new addition I don't think we've ever seen before is that Mikey has braces, so that's cool. Now for Raphael, the first thing to notice is he's got the do-rag look rather than the traditional Ninja Turtle mask. This is something that we saw in the 2014 film. He also wore it like this in the Rise of the TMNT, and yes, I know all the turtles kind of wore these in the original comic books sometimes, but it seems that this is becoming a more permanent attribute for Raphael himself. His body type is also thicker, a bit buffer than the other turtles, just like we saw in the 2014 film. Majorly saw this in Rise of the TMNT and in Batman vs. the TMNT, so this is very much a Viacom Nickelodeon attribute of Raphael for him to be thicker and buffer than the others. His skin color seems to be the traditional Raphael lime green, almost a chartreuse color, so that's cool. We can also see the top edges of the front of his shell spike out a bit, kind of like in Rise of the TMNT. And Raphael is also missing one of his front teeth, which is more reminiscent of Donatello from the 2012 show. And he also seems to have his more fun-loving attitude from Rise of the TMNT, rather than having his, you know, Debbie Downer, angry attitude kind of personality that he's had in more traditional turtle media. Speaking of Donatello, my favorite turtle, let's take a look at him. He seems to have that more pale olive green skin like he had in the promotional art for the 2003 show. He also sported this color in the 2012 show. He's also wearing glasses and has a set of headphones around his neck. These are both kind of a throwback to his 2014 design where he had glasses and headphones just like that. And Donnie also has his purple cell phone that he had in the 2016 movie Out of the Shadows. I also want to note that the grip in the middle of his bow staff is brown like it would be on a Playmates action figure, rather than being wrapped in white like it is more traditionally. Next up is Splinter. First thing to notice about his design is his very thick head of hair with a mullet and sideburns. This is very similar to Lu Jitsu, Splinter's human form in Rise of the TMNT. He also seems to have a pink nose, similar to Remy from Ratatouille. His kimono is not maroon like usual, it looks more pink with sort of a plaid pattern on it. He's got a purple belt and he wears a white t-shirt underneath his kimono. Also, you'll notice he has a little nick in his left ear, possibly a reference to the 1990 film where Shredder slashed him in the ear. Next we have Bebop and Rocksteady, who appear to be wearing their exact outfits from the 1987 cartoon where they made their original debut. We have to note that Bebop is being played by Seth Rogen, who also played Pumbaa in the live-action Lion King. So this is his second time playing a talking warthog. Actually, third time if you count Chip 'n Dale Rescue Rangers. And Rocksteady is being played by John Cena, who previously played Baron Draxum in Rise of the TMNT. And last we have April, who rather than being an adult, is a fellow teenager, similar to how she was in the 2012 show and in Rise of the TMNT. Speaking of Rise of the TMNT, they seem to take a lot of inspiration from her design in that, especially with her having glasses. She also wears a yellow coat, very similar to what she wore in the 2014 film. However, she has her sleeves rolled up like April did in the 1987 cartoon show. She's also wearing white high tops, which are kind of similar to the white boots that she wore in that show too. And April also appears to be a reporter of some kind, like she's been many times before. And now some general notes. Obviously, the Turtles are super into pizza, like they should be. You notice they do use the word ooze instead of mutagen, just like in the second movie, Secret of the Ooze. At the beginning, they play a slow, dramatic version of the original theme song. The Nickelodeon logo is green instead of orange. This building they're hanging out on is called The Laird, a reference to Peter Laird, the co-creator of the Turtles. I'd also like to point out that since the cast has been revealed, Leatherhead is being played by Rose Byrne, and Wingnut is being played by Natasha Demetrio. Sorry if I said that wrong. So it seems that these hideous mutant monsters are now going to be gender swapped into women. Why not, right? I'd also like to point out that this movie does feature not just Wingnut and Leatherhead, but also Mondo Gecko and Ray Filet. So that is four of the original Mighty Mutanimals. So if this movie takes off, there could be a Mighty Mutanimals spin-off movie. Would you want to see that? Let me know in the comment section below. Thank you so much for watching, and let me know what you think of this for our Turtly Tuesday instead of an action figure review. I did spend the weekend trying to find the Holothon turtle figures for today, but then ended up doing this movie thing instead. Also, please let me know in the comments, which Holothon figures of these do you want to see me review next week? Have a fantastic day, and toast!